I'm Ruby Roberts and this is SWN.
Welcome to a very special edition of the SWN podcast. It is Christmas Day. This is our bonus edition episode, which I just thought about recording today. So, of course, it's last minute and very ill-equipped and ill-prepared. What I'm going to do is, so just to give you a bit of preamble, back in about 2009-2010, I did my first venture onto YouTube in a series called Ask Billy. And it was through initially a Bebo site called OSW, Old School Wrestling. Then we became Old School Wrestling Chat. And I went through loads of iterations and kept going with that. So from there, I did it on Bebo initially. That was the first episode went out to Bebo. Remember we used to do videos on Bebo, went into that corner. It was on there, which I don't have access to that episode anymore. I put them all on YouTube, put them on this exact same channel that you're watching if you're on YouTube right now, but I deleted them all. I got rid of them. I didn't want them anywhere in the world anymore because it was very cringe. It were just not good. They were really stilted and horrible to listen to and watch. So while I was just going through my subscriptions, I was deleting some subscriptions, unsubscribing, get rid of some stuff so I can kind of streamline my YouTube algorithm, so to speak. I found a channel called OSW Network. So this was kind of a thing we were trying to do through the Facebook page for Old School Wrestling Chat, OSW Chat 5, I think by that point it was called. And we invited members and admins and that to make their own videos. We would do like Q&As and all that kind of stuff. And I forgot that I uploaded some on there. I uploaded episodes of, well, I think I've just got two episodes possibly of Ask Billy on there. So as a festive treat, I'm going to watch an episode of it and provide some nice commentary with it and hopefully give you some background information and you can see me die in the corner as I cringe at the thought of just what an absolute tool I am. So it's going to be a quick episode of SWN podcast, and I hope this is a nice little treat for you to feel my pain and just to watch me absolutely cringe as I go through this. So we're going to try and share the screen. So it's technological, so it's always going to be a dodgy start. So it will be this one. Share the sound so you can hear it, because you'll definitely want to hear it. So here it is, OSW Network. So you can go onto YouTube and find it if you dare. 50 subscribers, reasonable. We've got some episodes and videos on there. So yeah, there's some terrible stuff on there. Something about Milk Wars, which I don't dare go check. There's the episode that I'm not going to go over because I started listening to it and oh my God, what a dick. I am. I also did some stuff where I went to Poundland. There we go. There's a Poundland stuff. See, they're cracking views here. I did some promos. And I feel like I've unlocked something that people are going to take advantage of in the future. Yeah, I've got that. Me swinging a belt between my legs. I loved wearing a belt as well. Doing the Daniel Bryan. What an absolute dick. So 10 years ago, I did these things. 10 years ago. So yeah, invite other folks, Paul, the now Keita Murray. If you check the PWI 500, you'll see his name. Here he was 10 years ago doing K-Man's Corner and all that jazz. So the one we're going to check out is classic Ask Billy debut episode, which I did start watching, as you can see, and I had to nope out because, what a knob. Right, so... So I'm going to pause it and go right back to the start. And hopefully I'll give you some insight and information on just everything here. So Ask Billy. It was a fun idea. I can't remember how many episodes I did initially. And like I say, they're all gone now, except like this one and one of the other ones that are on this particular channel. Because I had to get rid of them because they were just awful. It was a fun, it was a fun thing. Didn't break records. I think we got maybe about 20 views, 20, 25 views a time. And it was just answering questions from the guys at OSW chat, the guys and girls that would ask the questions, and we would have a bit of fun, and that would be it. All the editing, all the recording, and all the editing was all done through PlayStation 3, all of it. So at one point, I had two PS3s, not show off, and one and a TV that would dual screen. And so I would have on one side, I would have the questions, and one side I would have the recording through iCreate. And I edited it through iCreate, as you can see by this amazing bit of stuff here that's on there. This particular bit, this intro, is recorded in my first flat, my first proper flat, because I lived in Lossiemouth and what have you. But this is my first flat in Elgin. As you can see, the lighting is incredible. I think it was one of those very, very cheap yellow lights that's there. So of course the lighting was captured. I think that's my bedroom. No, that's my living room. Sorry, it's my living room that's there, because it's got a cracking canvas in the background there. Look at that. Look at that wallpaper, two-tone. Oof, sexy. And look at this state of this monstrosity with his hair and his attempt at facial hair, his little polo shirt, his beige jumper. So like I said, I've maybe l listened to maybe a minute of this, and I hated it. So we're gonna go through the 9 minutes together, hopefully, and hopefully, unless I just nope out. And I'll go through. I'll discuss maybe the answers, and add some nice commentary. So we're gonna go straight into it. Let's see how it goes.
Hi, welcome to the
What a dick.
first episode of Classic Ask Billy. As you may know, that I used to do a show on my YouTube channel, Voice
Oh, I had to get my own plug in straight away.
to OSW, called Ask Billy, where I answered questions set by the guys from OSW. So this from the OSW Network.
Oh, you could park a bike in that pause.
I'm going to have a little intro before the episode, and then I'll show the episode. This one is the very first episode I uploaded and put onto YouTube.
I didn't prepare this, as you can tell. I don't prepare now. I write notes now. But I don't prepare what I'm actually going to say in the episodes, and it's very obvious at this point. This is what I do.
As you can see, I'm very awkward and not very forthcoming with answers, but I obviously got better over time.
Oh,
As you can see, because I'm not awkward at all when I'm doing this intro.
the confidence in that man.
Anyway, bit of a footnote for Ask Billy. Ask Billy initially started as Ask Davin
Fuck doing second takes.
our Bebo site, that basically anyone could ask Davin a question and Davin would answer it. I thought that's a fucking great idea. Don't know why I swore.
I don't know either. I don't know why you swore. There's no need for it.
Script. Thought that was a great idea and I thought, right, I'll do something similar. So I'd ask Billy. They also merged from John Cena's Five Questions, or Five Questions with the Champ, as you may remember.
Nobody does. Nobody remembers Five Questions with the Champ. It was incredible. I loved it. I watched it that in Crime Times, like Word of the Week thing and the Dirt Sheet. Amazing.
Back in about 2005, 2006. So here's the first episode of Ask Billy, and enjoy it, and I hope you stay tuned for further episodes of Classic Ask Billy. Stay classy, OSW.
Dick. Right, so before we go any further, that was the intro. So of course I recorded that in 2012, I think it was. I recorded that bit. So I've got an upload date on it at all. I'm not sure. Right, I can't see if there's an upload date. Let's, show more. Right, so February 17th, 2012. So I probably recorded that February 16th, 2012, and that was one take. I wouldn't have done another take. Because why would I? And yeah, that was it. So that was in my flat in Elgin, and this particular specimen, this bit was recorded 2010. I think the date will pop up. I hope, because that's the kind of stuff I would do in there. This is recorded in Newport, Sligo. This is in my I live with my parents at the time, in this particular time. It was 20, no, 19, I think, maybe 20 when this episode was recorded. So there you go. I printed out, either printed out, or I'm fairly certain I wrote it down because I didn't have a printer. So I wrote down all the questions. There's a cool sting there. There's my bed. And of course, my title belts. That's probably a Divas calendar because, I was 20 and I thought that was cool. So here we are in my bedroom. Let's see what we've got. Let's see if I get a catchphrase.
Welcome to the Bill of Rights, and welcome to the second edition of Ask Billy.
Idiot. I went for Bill of Rights. That says all. Original air date 26th of March 2010. So yeah, I was 19 when this was done. Look at that. Look at that head of hair and that lack of facial hair. All right, let's do it.
This is the second time I've had to record this because I made a mistake, so
Oh.
I'm going to run through them quite quickly. Will Kane and the Undertaker getting done.
Right. Okay. So I know this is going to be a long episode because I'm going to find so many things wrong with this. So yeah, so I made a mistake. So I've had to re-record it. So I've taken the thought there that I'm just going to answer them quickly. You've never seen the first section. You've never seen the first bit. So you don't know what the initial long form answers were.
Inducted into the Hall of Fame together or at separate events from Damo. I think the Undertaker will be inducted first.
I was wrong.
Just because he's got the bigger persona, he's got the biggest. I mean, if you ask people who they've heard of in wrestling, anyone, they'll think Hulk Hogan, Steve Austin, the Undertaker. Undertaker will be inducted before Kane. Kane, essentially, since he lost his mask, has become
Became.
a main event jobber. It's unfortunate. I would love to see Kane getting our world title, but with the way that his career's gone since losing that mask, it's not going to happen.
Right, I'm going to double check something because I think he did win our world title after this. So Kane World, I think he won the Money in the Bank that year, didn't he? World champ. Yeah, let's see. This is fascinating, I know, but I can't let myself get away with this because it's awful. Let's see, Reigns. Kane. Yeah, he won the title July 18th, 2010, and this is recorded in March 2010.
Unfortunately, he will get inducted one day, but The Undertaker will be inducted first, in
Oh, he
my
was.
opinion. Okay, so it's from Damo. Second question is, which is your favourite WrestleMania match ever from Carlin?
Carlin, by the way, was a catfish. We never found out who it was. We had a good guess who it might have been. But she was not real. And I think a lot of the guys on OSW chat messaged her quite a lot. And yeah, that was, I'm fairly certain she was a catfish. She had two profile pictures, two pictures at all on her Facebook. That was it, two pictures. And they didn't look the same. And she always all went on about like having all these DVDs and that, but there were pictures that you could find on Google quite easily. So yeah, she was a catfish. There you go. Fun fact there.
I love TLC.
I do love TLC.
TLC 1, TLC 2, TLC 3, all.
Didn't need to name them all. But I am wrong at this point. I think it's probably panicking, thinking of a cool answer, but the real answer is Edge versus Mick Foley at WrestleMania 23. Which hang on, which year was that? Because it might not have happened at that point. WrestleMania 23. 23. It happened in 2007. So yeah, that is my favorite match of WrestleMania.
All the TLCs. I love ladder matches, all things like that. So TLC, Edge and Christian versus Matt and Jeff versus the Dudleys. I loved it. It's one of my favorite matches of all time. It screamed car crash and anything that involves people going through lots of tables, I will watch.
Favorite match is Edge versus Mick Foley at WrestleMania 23. So that makes sense with the table thing. So there you go. I don't know why I need to go Matt and Jeff, not just mention Colin and Hardy's when I call the Dudleys the Dudleys, but here we go.
Right, which member of the Troll Brigade, Tommy Rice, Kurt Cobain, Carl James, pissed you off the most from Davin?
So right. So David was the kind of the real owner, the head cheese of OSW chat. So he would be the guy that would be he would be the leader. He created it really. He brought on myself as an admin, and he brought on Jay Hunter as an admin as well. Of course, Jay Hunter's went on to do amazing things at OSW Review. And then we expanded and brought in more admins and what have you. So with admins, you get trolls as well. So here's my thoughts on that.
I don't remember Tommy Rice blowing up. I heard of it, and I knew Tommy Rice was pretty weird, but I wasn't actually around when he went a bit nuts, so I wouldn't class that because I just wasn't there for it. Kurt Cobain.
That one happened on Bebo, I think. I took a break from Bebo, or like I started my job. So I started at the job I'm in now. Obviously, I've moved department since. But yeah, I started my job there. No, it wasn't that. It was because I'd moved house, so I didn't have as much time on the internet because I had to drive from Elgin to Newport Sligo every day, back and forth. By the time I got home, I was knackered and dead. But also because we're quite lax with the internet. Obviously nothing seedy at all, but at that point you could get onto like people and social media and stuff like that. And I think right about the time that Tommy Rice stuff, they'd really crack down on like anything fun you could go on the internet. You just had to go on to work stuff. That's all you could do. So that's why I wasn't really around for that Tommy Rice blow up.
Well, it pretty much killed OSW and then OSW 2. But even then, it was quite fun to see everyone going mental, like Shano, going absolutely apeshit towards the end of it. Carl James, the Cinemark. Now, I was a Cine fan.
I still was at this point. I won't lie. I was just trying to be cool. Because I was 19. But yeah, I still was. There's a reason why I started disliking him a little bit. But really, it's John Cena. He's always been cool.
I was Cena fan for quite a while. I'm not like a, ooh, Cena!
There we go.
But I didn't hate him until he started doing that, and now it just kind of, he pisses me off every turn.
That did annoy me for a bit. I'm not gonna lie. Also, my friend did a impression of Michael Cole every time we saw John Cena, which what made me want to punch him in the face.
But Carl James was just such a large Cena mark. I mean, I've never seen, I mean, women and children.
Missed a great pun there. Never seen her.
Don't support Cena that much like this little twat did. So I'm gonna go for Carl James just because he got on my nerves quite a lot.
Got on me nerves.
That's that one. Do you think there's anything fishy about Hardy's arrest from David? I found it fishy
Oh, nice and controversial.
that he was arrested not long after he left WWE. So I think someone knows something, or someone might have planted something.
Nice. I'm gonna get my tinfoil hat, I think. Wow. What a nerd.
I'm not accusing anyone, but I just find it a bit suspicious that he was arrested after he left WWE.
Isn't it weird that that has also happened very recently? So this is 2010, and then that happened again. What, 20, this year was it? 2022? Oh, weird.
What's your favourite wrestling theme? From Patrick S. The Hardy Boys. Every time, the Hardy Boys.
Yeah, I'll give him that. That's still right.
It just gets your blood flowing, you're pumped, you're ready for their matches, and the way they came out, the crowd went mental. It was just the best thing ever. Right, so next question, which do you prefer so far, WWE or TNA, and why? Fool the world.
I liked TNA, so we'll see what my answer was at this point. So this is 10, so this was Hogan stepping in. So I wonder if I've got any spicy opinions about that.
TNA. I could watch it every week. I mean, I have to go on YouTube if I want to watch SmackDown or Raw or NXT, with the exception of NXT, if I miss Raw or SmackDown. Made that fuss, to be honest.
Didn't really watch NXT either, so I don't know what I'm going on about. Being fussed about watching NXT, and I still watch Raw and SmackDown like that now, t 12 years later.
So TNA, just because I enjoy the show and I can watch it every week without fail. In your opinion, the greatest storyline of all time before 2001 from Luke Hall. A couple I could think of. Triple H, Cactus Jack.
Give him that one. Yep, you're still right there, past Billy.
The whole Hardys and Edge and Christian, even the Invasion. I quite liked the Invasion because I wasn't that aware
Quest was before 2001.
of ECW and WCW. I knew they existed, but other than that, I wasn't quite sure. I watched WCW Worldwide.
Channel 5, blaze up.
There's quite a lot of storylines that I loved before 2001, so I couldn't pick a greatest one. Even Steve Austin. In general, just Steve Austin McMahon, that was amazing as well.
Started watching wrestling in about 98, 99. I didn't really see a lot of Austin McMahon. It's probably more retrospective going back. So yeah, I'm still gonna. I would still probably answer Triple H Mick Foley if we're going pre 2001. Invasion happened in 2001, so I don't think I would class that. I would use that as an answer now, in fairness. But yeah, I would probably still go Triple H Cactus Jack and Mick Foley and all that jazz.
Great storyline after 2001 for Luke again. Not as many to choose from,
Bollocks.
but I'm gonna go for Matt Hardy when he became Version One and tried to win the Cruiserweight title, which he did eventually.
All the choices I had there. So this is what 2001 and 2010, and I chose Matt Hardy version one. That's the one I went with. Not Jesus stabbing John Cena. No, went for that one.
Great matches with Billy Kidman. Had a brilliant stormer with Rey Mysterio at WrestleMania 19, and it really showed that Matt Hardy can work in the mic department. I think he was very good in that time. He still is.
I love the Hardy Boys, what can I say?
Who is your favorite tag team of all time, and which team do you think should never have been, i.e., worst team, Mr. Wrestling?
Right. I think we can all make a good guess of what my favorite tag team is going to be just from this 6 minute video so far. But you know, I can surprise you.
Best tag team, favorite tag team, Hardy Boys. No doubt in my mind. That everything they had, they were just the best team ever, in my opinion. Everyone in OSW will know that I think that, and I will never change that opinion. Worst team, there's quite a lot. Ding and Dong, from T.
I choose a TNA one that I've probably never seen. I just heard and seen pictures of.
The Dicks from WWE.
I'll give him that one. Oh yeah, okay, fair enough. Yeah, the dicks were pretty bad.
Anything involving Rico, with the exception of Billy and Chuck.
That's a shame. I liked Hoss and Rico, and I don't know what I was talking about at the time. You know, but all that hair must be just affecting my brain.
There's quite a lot of really bad teams in the world, and that's just a couple. So that was from Mr. Wrestling. Do you think AJ Styles and Ric Flair together was a good idea, and why, Matt Rydell?
Right, okay, so we're yeah, that's 2010 TNA. Yeah, Hogan era. No, I actually think I didn't mind Hogan era TNA at first. There's a bit just batshit and all that kind of stuff. But when they got rid of the six sides, that's where I started really getting a bit yeah. Get a bit just like non-interesting about it. Because that was their difference. That was the cool thing about it. They had their six-sided ring. So we went to four sides. Just to get his interest. I like Joker Sting though. Remember Joker Sting? That was cool.
I think it gives AJ Styles more mic time that he desperately needs. All he does really is shout in his Georgia accent, which can get a bit grating. But the more time he has on the mic and in front of people talking, the better it can be. Surely it is getting a bit better every time. With Ric Flair just looks like a saggy ball bag that someone's put a face on.
There's your line. Favorite wrestler Jeff Hardy, you know, I'm just saying I'm criticizing AJ Styles for shouting with an accent, and my favorite wrestler is Jeff Hardy.
So he is a bit of a hindrance, but at least it's given AJ Styles more time on the mic as well. But Ric Flair should really put his trunks in the fire because I don't want to see him wrestle ever, ever, ever again.
That was his last match in 2022. There we go. He faked a heart attack during it, so. Well, it was advertised as last match, you know, it's Ric Flair. By the time this comes out, it's probably got another match scheduled.
Right, so it's from Matt. And last question I've got this week. What's your first ever memory of wrestling? Next big thing.
Right. So the right answer, which hopefully is the answer I use, will be Undertaker setting fire to a teddy bear in front of Vince McMahon. That's the answer. So hopefully I've not tried to be cool and thought of something else. So here we go.
As I said before, I watched a bit of wrestling before this particular memory, but this memory stands in my mind and will probably stay in my mind forevermore. It was the Undertaker versus Kane Inferno match, the one where Kane got set on fire, and after the match, Undertaker took a box, pulled out a teddy bear, and burnt it in front of Vince McMahon.
This is why I should really have like notes or a bit of paper most of the time, because I've put down that bit of paper and look at my hands. They're just all over the place. I don't know what to do with them. I'm Ricky Bobby.
That gave me nightmares. I'm not joking. It gave me nightmares. It was so scary. And that really hooked me into wrestling, if it sounds weird, but that's what really hooked me into it, because I wanted to see what would happen. I wanted to see what Vince McMahon would do. I wanted to see what The Undertaker was going to do next. It was just amazing. Before that time, I'd watched Heat, I'd watched some WCW Worldwide, I'd watched some other stuff.
I don't think I did, because I don't think that was possible. Because I think that moment happened, what, 98? I didn't start watching Worldwide till 99, and Heat was later on that year, possibly the end of 98, start of 99. So yeah, I'm talking bollocks there.
But my first real memory that will live with me is that match and how much it scared me. Okay, so that's all the questions done this week. So next I'll do my rated R superstar
There we go. There we go. Here's PSD controller.
special, because Jeff asked me a heap of questions and I want to get them all done. This is also going to be on YouTube, I hope, because it's a bit longer than the rest of the videos I've done. But other than that, that's all done, and one last thing to say.
Oh, we've got a tagline. Hang on. We've got a tagline. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be? Is it gonna be amazing?
Done, and one last thing to say. Stay classy, OSW.
No, I don't want to start that again. I was as it wasn't as terrible as I thought it was going to be, God, waffled. I do that now still. So yeah, that was the first ever. It was the first ever YouTube episode of Ask Billy that I re-uploaded 2 years later onto OSW Network on YouTube. So if you want to find some more of my shenanigans, because I don't have access to this YouTube channel. I don't have access to it at all. Hang on, let's see this doing the Daniel Bryan. Hang on. Let's just why not?
Yes, yes, yes,
Oh no.
yes, yes.
No, let's come out of that. I can't watch that. What else have we got? I'm really right, okay, right. I know I sound like a dick in this one. So let's just So this might, hopefully this won't get me copyright. Right, so all the editing done I create still. I didn't think of just going right to the edges for this particular bit, so why would I do that? So this is the only edition, the extra edition I think the 2012. So it's called Who Wants to Be a Billionaire? So what's the intro theme I'm going to use? Bruno Mars hasn't taken that down. 10 years later, it survived. I didn't know how to do fades or anything like that because I didn't. It was iCreate. I had no idea how to do that. So I want to see how amazing I do with crashing, just killing that vocal. Even fade it out, didn't bother, why not? I miss that hoodie. Look at the hair thinning, of course. The beard still not growing. We're not gonna watch this whole thing. It's 30 minutes long, and I think I'm gonna die of embarrassment in the first couple minutes. That phone that I've got there, it was one of the best budget phones on what was the show called? Gadget Show. It was like 50 quid. It looked like a BlackBerry, but it wasn't a BlackBerry.
Welcome to Who Wants to Be a Billionaire?
Dick.
Sponsored by Coca-Cola.
Which I don't drink anymore. I don't drink full fat Coke.
And also buy Thai sweet chili plantations.
Yeah, I still eat them, in fairness. But like, look how thin I was.
Feel the burn.
So this is still the same flat. I've got my hoodie there. Got this old sofa that I got from. We're definitely not watching this episode, so I don't know why I'm still here. But I've still got my European belt, of course, on display. Right, okay, let's see how awkward the first bit is.
Big Daddy Cool Davin. Did you go?
Why would I read? Why would I A, re-record it? And why would I prep? Why would I prepare and read it before I actually read it? You know.
Back home just to make an edition of Ask Billy. No, I made an edition of Ask Billy just because I was going home. I thought, why not? I could upload it while I'm there, along with the other videos that I'm putting on the OSW network.
I could put like three more videos on, so you know, wasn't that great.
I'm going to keep Ask Billy on my own YouTube channel, and put everything else on the OSW network. How's married life? Fantastic as always, Davin.
Right. Okay. So this is 2012. I got my first proper girlfriend, and it was very whirlwind time, and she was an arsehole. So we will just leave that there. Let's skip, see what else I've got going on. Let's skip forward.
He sees fear in Cena's eyes, and Cena ignored him to look at his lame old dad in the crowd, then pulls some SpongeBob SquarePants cartoon faces and basically destroyed the segment with his lack of talent. Yeah, it would have been cool to see, but Cena's such a lame old that it doesn't really matter.
I still like seeing that at this point as well. So, you know, try to be cool. Let's skip it. See if I've got any more cool stuff going on.
Post 2005, and hopefully something will change soon. What'd be your ultimate dream match? I don't know, there's a lot that have taken place, a lot have happened.
Acting. Let's see. See, I've got a Poundland DVD. Oh no, it's Back to the Future. Sweet. Why am I got that? Why am I got that?
Rain Man is one of my favorites, but recently I forgot how good these films were. Back to the Future. I watched the first one constantly. I watched it again this morning. And also, I watched Back to the Future 2 last night. And we're going to get Back to the Future 3 tomorrow. And it's fantastic. Favourite actor?
I mean, they are great films, so that's fair.
Again, so many. Michael J. Fox and that, and Christopher Lloyd as well. I'm a big fan of Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, still am. That's fine.
Ben Affleck, I'm a big fan of as well, along with Matt Damon. There's a
I must have watched Good Will Hunting very recently when I did that particular episode. Right, let's move forward. Let's see. I saw I did a thumbs up. I want to know why. Thumbs up. Let's see. Here we are.
What teams will you be cheering on in Euro 2012? A team for England.
Oh, we're getting rebel here.
No, Ireland as well. Top five wrestlers you hate and why? Charles Guerrero, because he's a dick. No.
He blocked me on Twitter. But it was absolutely deserved. I actually met him later that year in 2012. I went to my first Scottish wrestling show in the August of 2012, and this episode was done on in May, so it would have been done probably April. So yeah, I met Chavo Guerrero later that year, and he was really nice, and I met him again like in 20 something at WrestleZone as well. So yeah, he was really nice both times. I think it was a right knob. So I've been 21 at that point. Can't remember when it happened, but it was my first time on Twitter. I thought I was an edgelord, and I was so super cool by telling Chavo Guerrero through Twitter that he was feeding off Eddie Guerrero's legacy. It was a dick. I don't know, it was a dick. I was just, yeah, it was not the best time for me.
We blocked them on Twitter.
Oh, and I'm so fucking proud of it in this. Right, okay, right, we're going forward. Let's turn on.
Because I was an asshole, but
Oh, at least I kind of knew I was an asshole at that point.
don't care.
I did care.
Get paid lots of money. I can be a fucking asshole if I want to be.
Oh, what a dick. I hate you. I hate you, past Billy. Right, what else we got? That's
Porn.
oh, that's a weird word to come straight onto. Let's go back a bit.
All those terabytes of porn, now you're with Leona.
Oh, let's move on because I don't want any more mention of that. And I didn't need to store it. Anyway.
Recent remake of Walking Tall, as in not the shitty two sequels that we've seen already, one with Rock again, that'd be good.
Yeah, I can't. I'll go see if I've got a little catchphrase. Oh, remember. Let's see. You can go check us out on OSW Network. I'd rather you didn't, but you know, if you do, please let me know. Let's see if I've got a sign off.
So, that was it. Hope you enjoyed this latest edition of Ask Billy.
I'm so pale.
And see you around. Stay classy, OSW.
All created on iCreate. Billy dot your face. What a dick. Yeah, okay. We don't need to see anymore. So that's it. Let's stop sharing there. Let's go back. Okay, so that is the ghost of Christmas past that I'm visiting there on the special edition on SWN podcast. So I hope you enjoyed that. I've got a couple questions on Twitter that I'm gonna answer. And then you can go back and enjoy whatever you want to do on this fine Christmas day. Let's see what we've got. So we've got Callum. I'll of course ask you a few questions. Nice questions there. Rumble winner for WWE and WrestleZone. So yeah, for forget that. If you're this far and you've watched that monstrosity and you've went on to OSW Network, like I say, please let me know. I would like to at least know that people are revisiting this, and I'm sure someone may gift something of me doing something terrible, saying something terrible. There is some other videos on there that I'm not particularly proud of, and like I say, I can't delete. So I've got those. So anyway, right, couple questions. Rumble winner, WWE or and WrestleZone. WWE, it's hard to look past Cody Rhodes at this point, but who knows? It's Rumble season. There's no real clear cut who's gonna win. I'd love it to be Sami Zayn. That'd be quite cool as a cool underdog story. He might win it by nefarious means or shenanigans or by mistake. And then that would be quite a cool thing that happens for him and Roman Reigns. But you know, Rumble season, I love Rumble season. So that means I'm gonna get the once Christmas and New Year is past, I'm gonna be on WWE Network constantly watching old Raw Rumbles. For WrestleZone, right now, it's Caleb Valhalla. That's my favorite. That's my favorite to win this year because I've got this kind of thing. I want to see Caleb and Aspen in the main event of Aberg Anarchy. I know they're wrestling in February for Discovery, but you know, it could happen again. It could happen again in May or whatever. May's like, Fabianaki is in May this year. So yeah, I would love to see that. That's my kind of pick at the moment. But I'm terrible at predicting these things for WrestleZone. I'm just awful at it. So who knows? Will WrestleZone venture further than Ellen? I would love them to come back to Keith again, selfishly, so I could go. If they go to Keith, though, I would more likely take Jack with me because I'd be quite close by. That would be fun, and I'd probably get a good group of folk, get my brother to go as well, and I'd drag Kelly too, because she'll probably want to be there with Jack as well. So that would be the dream. Get back to Keith. I'd love them to try Bucky. I know they did them way back when, and then United Pro did it as well. But you got a semi decent crowd, a decent sized crowd in Bucky, so I wouldn't mind them doing Bucky again. That'd be cool. Just this way, I would just like to see more shows this way. Huntley, maybe go back to Huntley. Any really anywhere that means I'd have to travel less. That's just the selfishness of that particular question there. So those two questions have got in. There'll probably be somewhere that'll filter in, but it's too late now. I've recorded the episode. So thank you for joining me in this walk down memory lane, this ghost of Christmas past, this blast from the past for the SWN podcast at Christmas. We have some fun stuff, hopefully in the pipeline for 2023. The next episode should be the SWN year end awards. Well, as of this coming out, you will have seen that our SWN 100 has been released, and congratulations to Taylor Bryden for being number one. It was a really cool thing to do this year, and I'm like, hopefully get some good feedback, and I'll do it again next year for the SWN 100. And that's it. So there should be year end awards. Let me next. I've got some stuff in the pipeline that possibly will happen in the new year. I'm possibly thinking doing the SWN podcast season 5. Fortnightly, that'd be kind of that's my kind of thought right now. So it gives me a little bit of breathing room, a bit of time. But we'll just soon see. So thank you again for supporting SWN and the SWN podcast and Scottish Wrestling Network in general and Scottish Wrestling. You can visit us at swnscotland.com. You'll find me on Twitter, twitter.com/scottresnet. You can find me on Facebook as well at that. I don't use Facebook as much. I'm really a Twitter guy. So if you want to find me, contact me. That's probably the best place for it. Instagram.com/scottresnet also, and you can find all the podcasts on YouTube and also on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. So Merry Christmas, folks. Go get pissed and eat a shit ton of food. Have a good one.